leave encashment is disallowed if the payment is not made. The disallowance is under Section 43B. Exide Industries had raised constitutional validity of disallowance of leave encashment if not paid. The Supreme Court has unwinded the nitty-gritties of the law and decided the matter against the assessee. Here goes the entire case breakup. Exide Industries Limited computed their profits and gains of business in accordance with the mercantile system. As per the mercantile system, income and expenditure are determined on the basis of accrual or provision and not on the basis of actual receipt or payment. Assessing officer, while assessing income, invoked Section 43B, Clause F, and disallowed the provision made under the leave encashment scheme. Aggrieved, assessee filed an appeal and the matter reached up to Calcutta High Court. Calcutta High Court held that the provisions of Section 43B, Clause F, as arbitrary and unconstitutional. Aggrieved, revenue filed an appeal before Supreme Court. Key contentions of the assessee challenging the constitutional validity of Section 43B. Section 145 offers the choice of method of accounting, that is cash accounting or mercantile accounting, and Section 43B carves out certain exceptions to the general rule of accrual for determination of liability as it subjects deductions based on actual payment. Assessee contends that Section 43B applies only with respect to statutory liabilities like tax, duty, cess, etc., and other liabilities created for the welfare of employees. The leave encashment scheme, being a trading liability, cannot be subjected to the exception under Section 43B. Assessee relied on Supreme Court judgment in case of Bharati Earth Movers, wherein it was held that liability in lieu of leave encashment scheme was a present and definite liability and not a contingent liability. Assessee submitted that as such, leave encashment liability is carved in nature of a beneficial provision and leave can only be encashed by the employees in accordance with the terms and conditions of employment. Further, the assessee submitted that since the due date for encashment of leave does not arise in the same accounting year in which provision is made, there is no question of subjecting the deductions against such liability upon actual payment. Assessee also contended that enactment of Clause F was driven by the sole consideration of subjugating the legal position in Bharat Earth Movers without removing the basis thereof. Assessee also contended that the liability covered under Clause F is of a completely distinct nature and without specifying clear objects and reasons for the inclusion of this liability under Section 43B, it cannot be slipped into the main section. Further, the assessee also submitted that the nature of this liability is neither in sync with the objects and reasons of the original section nor with those of other clauses enacted from time to time in different assessment years. Key observations and the decision of the Supreme Court. Supreme Court examined Clause F on the touchstone of the Constitution by applying a twofold test laid down by coordinate bench in Rakesh Kohli's case, stating that the legislative power of the Parliament to enact Clause F in the light of Article 245 is not doubted at all. Supreme Court went on to examine the next step, that is, whether the said clause contravenes any fundamental right enshrined in Constitution. Supreme Court pursued Section 145, which prescribes the method of accounting, and observed that Subsection 2 thereof unambiguously empowers the central government to prescribe income computation and disclosure standards for accounting. Subsection 2 signifies that the general principle of autonomy of the assessee in adopting a system of accounting is controlled by the regulation notified by the central government and must be adhered to by the class of assessee governed thereunder. Supreme Court stated that Section 43B neither placed an embargo upon the autonomy of the assessee in adopting a particular method of accounting, nor did it deprive the assessee of any lawful deduction, but merely operated as an additional condition for the availment of deduction. Referring to the memorandum to Finance Bill 1983, which introduced Section 43B, Supreme Court noted that the provision was introduced to curb certain practices of evasion of statutory liabilities and other liabilities for the welfare of employees. Supreme Court noted that though initially the provision included deduction only with respect to tax or rate or any contribution to provident fund or superannuation fund, over the years the scope has enlarged to include bonus, cess, interest payable to financial institutions, which clarified that there was no uniformity in the nature of deductions. Thus, Supreme Court rejected the SSC's contention that Section 43B only provides for deduction of statutory liability and leave encashment being a trading liability would not be covered. Explaining the mischief intended to curb by Section 43B Clause F, Supreme Court stated that allowing employers to take advance deduction upon creation of provision entailed him with double benefit, deduction from tax liability and refusal to pay when the event arises. Supreme Court opined that, in line with other clauses under Section 43B Clause F, was enacted to remedy a particular mischief and the concerns of public good, employees' welfare and prevention of fraud upon revenue is writ large in the said clause. Calcutta High Court's reasoning for ruling against the validity of the provisions. Non-disclosure of objects and reasons behind its enactment and insertion into Section 43B. Inconsistency of Clause F with other clauses of Section 43B and absence of nexus of the clause with the original enactment. Enactment has been triggered solely to nullify the dicta of this court in Bharat Earth Movers. Non-disclosure of objects. Supreme Court clarified that the express objects and reasons of enactment of a legislature serves the purpose of assisting the court in examining the validity of a provision, especially when the court is sitting over the interpretation of an ambiguous provision. The presence or absence of objects and reasons has no impact upon the constitutional validity of a provision, as long as the literal features of the provision enable the court to comprehend its true meaning with sufficient clarity. Supreme Court remarked that High Court plainly glossed over the fundamental presumption of constitutionality in favor of Clause F and based its judgment upon the absence of objects and reasons as striking at the root of its validity. Supreme Court opined that this approach of High Court was flawed on three counts. 1. It steered clear from the necessary attempt to discover any constitutional infirmities in the enacted provision. 2. It made no attempt to dissect the text of the provision so as to display the need to go beyond the text. And 3. It goes into the background of the enactment and ventures into a sphere which is out of bounds for the court as long as the need for interpretation born out of any ambiguity arises. Supreme Court stated that the non-disclosure of objects and reasons per se would not impinge upon the constitutionality of a provision unless the provision is ambiguous and the possible interpretation violate Part 3 of the Constitution, and in the absence of any finding of any constitutional infirmity in a provision, the court is not empowered to validate a provision. Supreme Court remarked that to hold a provision as violative of the Constitution on account of failure of the legislature to state the objects and reasons would amount to an indirect scrutiny of the motives of the legislature behind the enactment, which is unwarranted. Supreme Court noted that High Court had held Section 43B Clause F as unconstitutional without actually undertaking an actual exemption of Clause F. Supreme Court clarified that merely holding an enacted provision as unconscionable or arbitrary is not sufficient to hold it as unconstitutional unless such infirmities are sufficiently shown to exist in the form, substance, or functioning of the impugned provision. Inconsistency of Clause F and absence of nexus with Section 43B. Supreme Court stated that both these grounds were ill-founded. Supreme Court clarified that the legislature never restricted it to a particular category of deduction and that intent cannot be read into the main section by the court while sitting in judicial review. Supreme Court also clarified that the broad objectives of enacting Section 43B concerning specified deductions referred to therein was to protect larger public interest, primarily of revenue, including welfare of the employees, and clause F fit into that scheme and shared sufficient nexus with the broad objective. Defeating the dictum in Bharat Earthmovers case. Though Supreme Court accepted that the legislature cannot sit over a judgment of Supreme Court or overrule it, Supreme Court stated that once the enactment itself stands corrected, the basic cause of adjudication stands altered and necessary effect follows the same. Supreme Court stated that the amendment does not reverse the nature of the liability, nor has it taken away the deduction as such. The liability of leave encashment continues to be a present liability as per the mercantile system of accounting, but merely defers the benefit of deduction to be availed by the assessee for the purpose of computing his taxable income and links it to the date of actual payment thereof to the employee concerned. Thus, the only effect of the insertion of clause F is to regulate the stated deduction by putting it in a special provision. Supreme Court stated that such the clause F is in sync with other deductions specified in section 43B, which are also present and accrued liabilities. Supreme Court remarked that merely because a certain liability has been declared to be a present liability by the court as per the prevailing enactment, it does not follow that legislature is denuded of its power to correct the mischief with prospective effect, including to create a new liability, exempt an existing liability, create a deduction, or subject an existing deduction to new regulatory measures. Thus, the plea that clause F has been enacted with the sole purpose to defeat the judgment of this court is misconceived. Thank you for a patient hearing. In order to get more such videos, kindly subscribe this channel and click on bell button to receive new videos in real time. Please like the video in order to encourage to make more such videos.